And that's when suicidal thoughts started to kick in. It wasn't that I didn't have any friends. Things were good, actually, that was the problem. The support around me was giving me anxiety, so I felt the need to cut everyone off, to make people just not want to be around me, to make them hate me. So, I don't know, girlfriend had to destroy that, and just slowly isolated myself. It's hard to be around other people when you can't even be around yourself, if that makes any sense. I was already convinced that, well, I gave myself negative affirmations. I am depressed. This is the way it's going to be. And not knowing that's the direction that I was most comfortable in. So anything that could have helped, well, I wasn't trying anything. So, I hit 23, and then that's when everything just kind of lined up. So I was just by the tracks, and then I just kind of walked myself through it, and I ended up
love you, Dill.
When it wasn't until a couple years later, I guess I had kind of just, that didn't work, and so, I don't know, you start to try to figure out different things to kind of just get through the day. If I could wake up and pass out as quickly as possible, that was kind of my goal. So I'd wake up, some days it'd be like, I'd wake up purposely at like 11 o'clock, then the liquor store's open, and I wouldn't make it back home. I'd pass out, been reported for a missing person. Got into trouble with the cops. It just got, I don't know. When you're running, it just, the monster becomes really, really big. I couldn't look people in the eyes anymore. The disassociation from my body and what was going on in my head was just too much. And then by that point, I don't know, I was just, things were just so chaotic, and then my nephew was born blind. And that, you would think that would be a shock, but when somebody you love is born with a disability like that, that you can physically see and mine's all in my head, it brought me back to here and here. This little baby who now has had his eye removed and has to go by the end of the year to have his other eye removed. And that's kind of hard to deal with, but he is such a joy to be around. And he, I don't know, I was so stubborn that it took something that drastic to kind of go, whoa, you can, like, it was just that exchange of love. And then the way that he would look up to me and just, I don't know, it started something, and then I just kind of, I felt the need to do something, maybe to talk to other people with disabilities. So, yeah, it just, one thing after another, just connecting with friends then again. I don't know, you can't go without friends. I've been isolated if, yeah, it gets lonely, and then you have no one to talk to, so.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, everyone is struggling in a one way. It might be blind, you might have anxiety, you might have, I don't know, maybe a, like a bone disease or something that forces you into a wheelchair. You need other people. And so if you're struggling, you got to find one person that you trust and just tell them, hey, things aren't right and I need to make some changes, but I can't do it alone. So we're a team. Hopefully that encouraged some of you. Sorry to get emotional, but yeah, it felt good.